Shrek, you know, I've started this vlog or episode twice now, okay? I started up the hill, we got close. I started, I already did one intro, and then all of a sudden, you know, I decided we're going to go ahead and try to get in here. That's where I got to go. I got to go through this valley first. And what I decided was, you know, I looked at my microphone, it wasn't working. And I was like, oh my God, I can't go over there and not have my microphone working. What would that be? So I came back and I started back up the hill. And then I looked again and all of a sudden it's working. So I don't know if I got a glitch. I mean, I've not had any problems with my equipment. The equipment's been stellar. I can't bitch about that at all. But you know, it is one thing that happened. So I got halfway over here. I'm checking my meter. I'm only 0.25 away. Right there is my target. I've got this ravine I have to try to get down, and man, it don't look like nothing, but trust me, it is. And now I got to figure out how I'm going to get through this mess. But you know, then I started back because there's no reason to go over there if you're not going to shoot, right? And go through this mess, and now I'm back. And so now I'm thinking about, okay, do I go back over there? Because I've already burned the energy. The good news is we had the coordinates we got from Google Earth. So we do know where it's at. It's not like we're roaming around here lost, which is definitely a plus if you do this. That, you know, I've done it plenty of times without coordinates, even though John thinks I'm insane. And you know what? He's actually correct. But now I'm walking through here. I'm looking for the fort called Charlie. Okay, and we have been thwarted numerous different ways of trying to get through here already, and every road we've come to has either been private property or we missed it. And so we came in the back way, and I don't know what we got going on here. So all we can do is try to get down in here without killing ourselves. See, that's what I've got to deal with right there. So I don't know how big this ditch is when I get down in there, but you know, normally this would have been a cake one. It would have been a walk right in, drive up, and you'd have been done. But as you can see, that is not the journey that I have in front of me. As you can see, I've got a mess. Now we got some animal pass through here, which is sometimes a plus and sometimes a negative, depending on what animals you have. Now we're going to try to work through here, figure out what we got and how to get in and how to get out. We got another ravine to go through. I'll tell you what I thought was going to be this easy, quick journey, it's got to be a journey. All I got to do is pop over that hill, which seems easy, but the journey down this hill, and then the next journey is finding my way out of here. Now, I know where I have to go, but how to get there, and it looks like we got another creek bed on top of this creek bed. So hopefully there's trails through here that will make this easier than it looks. It looks like if I just follow the animal trails, because there's a pretty good trail right here, I can make it out of here and up that ridge. it looks like maybe I'll be in luck. The hard thing is going to be is remembering where I came through. Now this looks sweet right here, so I got extremely lucky right here to come through here. So here's one thing I'm going to do is I'm going to tie a bandana right here just so I can find the area that I came through to go back in there, because that was easy comparatively. So there's my bandana and here is my journey. So let's work up here. I could have picked a better bandana for, don't use black, how's that? But it's the one tree right there lining up with the tree at top. So there's my guide. That's how I'm gonna try to get out of here, that way. So let's work up here and see if we can't find the fort called Charlie. But we've got the hardest part done, I think. I say that, but I'm not sure of that. Now there's a road up here. We got one more creek to come down, and we should be there. Tell you what, you know, you try to get out here and escape, and you can't escape your phone. Your phone's pretty much in, even out here in the middle of nowhere, which I guess is good if you got to call somebody, but I got a walkie-talkie. So just can't get away sometimes, can you? So I'm gonna work my way through here, go through here. I don't remember the pictures of Charlie, so I'm gonna kind of have to go off my gut, keep looking back, making sure I remember which cactus that was. Right there, the one, the big one on the point. Carry the big ones on the point. Just gotta remember that point, right there. Okay, so let's move up this hill. We got one more hill to crest. Now remember, these are forts, so I'm not expecting it to be easy. So I do know there's a road up here though, and I'm going to take it. What we're also going to do, stack a few rocks in this road. So when I come down right there, I won't miss it. Then I'll run back straight through there, work down that hill, and we will go up this road. Okay, right here, 0.13, right there. Right there, I've come from over there. We crossed that ridge. There's where I was earlier, on the top of that mountain right there. So that's where I was at earlier today. You know, we could have damn near probably walked over here. Well, I better not say that because that could be garbage. So we're checking out why they have these. Why would they have a fort there and then a fort here? What would be the purpose of that? So there must be the road where you got to stay out. So what we've done is we've come in here kind of the back way, and I didn't pass any signs at all that said that we were trespassing. So I'm going to take it that we're not. So we're running up this ridge right here, came up that road. Okay, the truck's parked on the other side of that ridge there. So however we should have taken this, you know, we didn't. So we're gonna march up here, take a look at Charlie. I've definitely got a trail, so that's nice. It's nice of somebody to make a trail for me. People have definitely used this trail. Whew. You know, when you're hurrying, because it's getting later in the day, you know, when you can just be calm, it's pretty cool. But it gets tough. You're trying to hurry. So we're gonna get up here to the fort they call Charlie. And hopefully we're dialed in. Now, this wouldn't have been nearly as difficult of a fort if you're going to come up. Wouldn't have been easy, but it wouldn't have been anything near what we were dealing with before. That's the way I went down. So it'd be ashamed if you couldn't get up here, actually. Now here's a little more interesting than where you could defend it a little more. I'm gonna get my gauge out. It says now 341 feet, so I could be pretty damn close now. Can't believe that there's fence here. Feet. Gotta be getting close. Here they are. Right here. The first signs of wall. Wow. How amazing is this? Now there is Delta. We're at Charlie. And this is a big area up here. Big area. You know, here we are. Another defensible position. And look at this one. We're dead center on it. And look what's here. Look at all the stuff. Really incredible. Really an incredible place. Now that's a nice wall right there. Look at that wall. That is unbelievable, right there. Beautiful wall. Don't see too many walls that pristine at all. Look at that wall. Isn't that spectacular? Look at that beautiful wall. That's really incredible. What an incredible wall that is. Wow. That's unbelievable. Now, these are the things in our history that we have to protect. Again, this is called Delta, or not Delta, but Charlie. Charlie, or Delta's over there, and then this is Charlie here. So, look how incredible this place is. Unbelievable. We wander through here. How incredible is this? We're able to find this. Wow, how neat is that? And there's a road right there. Goes down that hill. Absolutely unreal. Wow. Man, you just never know what you're going to get out here in the state of Arizona. My gosh, isn't this spectacular? Wow, look at this wall. This area. You know, we got to hustle through the area and get back, but I just wanted to show you guys the fort they call Charlie. And that's as good a wall as you're going to find anywhere right there. You know, that's about 6 feet in that part right there. How incredible is that? That is unreal. They had structures all through here. What an incredible sight. You know, what a journey we've had today, just following. Look at this. You know, man's creeping up on this area, you know. So it just tells you how much that we have to keep them protected, because, you know, people are just everywhere now. And with ATVs and UTVs, again, if you find shards, make sure you leave them. This is a big perimeter. Look at this thing. This is incredible. Really incredible. What a large structure this was. Really unbelievable. I tell you, I am fascinated by this structure. Well, guys, I tell you what, we got to make it back to the truck. And that's going to be a journey in itself to get back over there where we were and to find our roads back. But just take a look at this place. How cool is all this? Unbelievable. Wow. You know, to be able to see two places in one day is pretty incredible, actually, that I got to do this. Really incredible. I can't believe it. What an experience today. And you know, again, we're talking about warfare in the Southwest. We're talking about forts, you know. Why'd they need forts? Well, they need forts to protect themselves. No doubt about that. You know, they were definitely trying to defend themselves. That was the whole purpose of all of it. So we got an opportunity to be able to get in here and tell they're still here and they exist. It really is. It's incredible that we get a chance to see these things, and it, you know, they made their stand in these locations. How unbelievable is that? So we got to get over that ridge. See where that flat is over there? That's where we got to get to. So we got to climb through these hills, down these roads, and make our way back and try to figure out the right roads that they take, which may not be easy. Now, if we can just work our way back to the OFJ, we'll be in good shape, but I mean, I could have swore I stacked them more than high enough to be able to, there they are. And then you take them back down because you don't want anybody running their vehicle over it. So you'd make sure you take care of that. But there it is. There's my cairn right there. So let's move those. Don't want anybody running over those. So now the next thing we got to do is we got to find the cactus that we walked down to get to the drop-in location of where we're going. I don't remember if I'm on that side of the creek or on this side of the creek, but I'm gonna find out here pretty quick as I go through here. I got another drop down. You know, I don't see any of the things that I thought I saw last time I came through here at all. Well, I'm gonna take one last look. Delta Charlie, right there. I just made it around the corner. I should be able to see the truck when I cross this ridge right here. There they are, right there. So, wow. Now to find the others. I'm gonna guess that's one right there. So can anybody guess? I mean, why would they have four forts, right? Why would there be four forts? Where would the main population be out of? You know, that wasn't the most defendable area that I've seen. Maybe it's distance. Maybe you got a certain amount of time if you're in a certain area to get to a certain place, you know, and you can't make it all the way to Alpha or Bravo. So you go to the closest one and you just deal with whatever you've got. That could definitely be true. You don't really know that, but you know, they had common sense. And most of this stuff is going to be based on common sense. I mean, these are intelligent people. You know, even though they had primitive tools, but the brain was no different than today's. They just had more technology or less technology than we have today, but their brains were basically the same brain. So, you know, they knew what they needed to do. It wasn't a guess. So, I mean, if we can put our common sense to it, we can probably figure it out as well. You know, it probably had something to do with distance. If you couldn't get to one or you couldn't get to the other, you just wasn't out of luck. So that definitely could have been a lot of it. But you know, how fortunate are we today to be able to go back to these ancient locations that they battled? And just the sheer, if you've ever seen, fought somebody to the death, which I don't think most of us have, but how much energy it takes to battle like that. And after climbing these hills, even if you were in good shape like they were, you still had to climb these hills and wouldn't have the best advantage being a little tired. But how incredible was that today? I tell you what, I've had a great day. Hope you guys have too. Come along. Again, I want to thank all the Patreon people. I want to thank all the people that come to the show at 7 o'clock. And my two negative guys, Bobby Thumbs Down and Tommy Thumbs Down, I want to thank you guys for coming because it feels pretty damn good to live rent-free in your head. So, I love that. But I appreciate the people that watch. Appreciate the people that donate. 7 o'clock every Tuesday till 8:30. The show's expanding. We're going to have guests. We're going to have all kinds of stuff coming up in the new year. We're changing the whole format of the show. And it's going to be awesome. And we're going to carry this thing to the next level. And I appreciate all the support I get. And I always want to thank my wife and my daughter. for allowing me to do this. John and Maria, I mean, without them, I mean, it would be so much more difficult, and I appreciate them so much. Everybody that watches. Jace Reck, adios amigos, on the trail of the force in the desert southwest. Adios.